Hundreds of same-sex couples in Florida are fighting to get their loved ones' death certificates to reflect that they were married.
The state surgeon general is refusing to do this for people who were married before the Supreme Court ruled it legal. NBC2 chief political correspondent Dave Elias talked with one Southwest Florida woman who fought the state and won. Dave?
Yeah, there are actually two men in Florida who both lost their spouses after decades of being together. When they received their death certificate, it listed them as single, never married, although they were. Now, they're fighting to change that, and one Southwest Florida woman knows their fight all too well.
Carol and I were together for 47 years.
But the state of Florida refused to recognize Arlene Goldberg's marriage. When her wife Carol died, another shocking blow.
Her death certificate said that she was single, never married. And that just hit me wrong. I said, that is something that really hurt.
She joined eight other couples and filed suit against the state. She ultimately won and had the judge's ruling framed.
There is no good reason to further deny Ms. Goldberg the simple human dignity of being listed on her spouse's death certificate.
Despite that ruling from federal judge Robert Hinkle, hundreds in Florida are still fighting to get their loved ones' death certificates changed.
Her case is not different in any way. That's what makes this so shocking.
Karen Lowy is the attorney accusing Florida Surgeon General Celeste Philip of discrimination.
So essentially, the Department of Health is placing the burden of correcting the department's own unconstitutional discrimination on the victims of that discrimination.
Discrimination that Arlene Goldberg knows all too well.
I felt like a second-class citizen.
Now, we did reach out to the state surgeon general to find out why her office is not issuing accurate death certificates to some gay couples. Our questions haven't been answered. The matter is before Judge Hinkle. He could issue a ruling any day now. Live in the newsroom, Dave Elias, NBC2.